Hey everyone, it's Ross, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you guys the fig cuttings and one little trick I have that I bet you guys didn't know. What we have here is a tree that I got from a friend in California. You can see it's much larger than the other fig cuttings that I've been rooting, because this is already rooted out. He rooted this out and sent it to me late in the summer, early in the fall. And the tree just wasn't going to harden up in time, and it's a very valuable variety. So what I decided to do was to just protect this thing, right? I wanted to keep this away from the cold. It wasn't going to harden up in time, so the best bet I could do was bring it inside when temperature started to dip. And I also wanted to see if maybe I could grow this throughout the entire winter time, right? A lot of you guys have that urge. It's not something I recommend. But if you have a really strong plant that you think you can get through the wintertime and have it grow under lights for the remainder of the winter, you're gonna have a much healthier plant, a much better start to the season come spring. So you can certainly do this, but what I decided to do, instead of letting this thing grow and grow and grow, because it's already quite tall. I mean, look, it's higher than the lights. I have to raise the lights. I really want to bring the height of this thing down. So what I decided was, let me stick this tree here in the window of my upstairs bedroom. It's kind of cool up there. It's in like the 60s. When it's at nighttime by the window, it's probably even colder. Those colder temperatures are going to stop this tree from growing, number one. It's probably not going to set the tree into dormancy, but what it will do is kind of get this wood to harden up quite a bit. Once that wood hardens up, I can then take this tree and take cuttings from it. So that's what we're gonna do today, is I'm gonna take a cutting with my pruners here and show you guys where I'm gonna do this and how I'm gonna do this. And then that way you guys understand where I'm coming from and know that this is a possibility. The only downside is that this tree is actively growing. And of course, this wood isn't completely fully hardened. It's not completely lignified, but it is hard, and it's hard enough to root as a cutting. You don't necessarily need to have cuttings, guys, that are fully brown or fully hardened, but it is nice to have those two things if you're gonna be storing them in your fridge for a decent period of time. So let me cut this off. And you know, just to show you guys where I'm gonna cut it before I put you guys down, I'm probably gonna cut it all the way down to here. So let's do that. So there we have it, guys. Here's our new cutting. And you can see there's tons of sap at the bottom. Not the best scenario, obviously, but this is what we're dealing with. It's a nice little way of doing this. And then I'm gonna show you guys what the next step is. We need to take off the leaves. Take our grafting knife, or take our pruning shears here. Can't really get the camera to focus. There we go. But we're gonna score the bottom, like so. We're gonna take our parafilm here. We're gonna wrap the upper part of the cutting. I'm trying to get this camera to focus, guys. It's brand new. If you didn't know, I decided to upgrade my camera and treat myself to a nice little gift this holiday season. But we're just wrapping this cutting. Voila. And now we're gonna stick this in the soil, in the new pot. Stick that down in there. And now we have a new rooted cutting of the very special variety that is right next to it. And this guy here will certainly be fine. It's a strong enough tree. It will then send out probably new growth from the highest point, or a bud that maybe might be a bit more active. There's a lot of buds down here. And yeah, that's pretty much the video. That's the little tip I wanted to show you guys. So pretty cool. And this guy will, you know, probably be set back by a couple weeks, but that's a good amount of time to let these other ones catch up and kind of match, hopefully, the vigor of this tree, so that when I raise this light up, or I have to raise this light up, the rest of the plants can kind of be along right with it. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. More to come for rooting figs. So take care.